like, comment, and subscribe.
Now, normally, we don't talk about leaks because things can change, they can be unconfirmed, the sources could maybe not be credible, and things like that. But there was, relative to a recent video we made about the Ultimate Skins, a potential leak about the next Ultimate Skin being for a popular female AD carry over on Reddit. And someone in the Serenity 20 comment section tried to roughly translate it, saying that it might actually expand to just AD carries in general, like possibly Jhin or Teemo even, for that matter. But it's going to be an AD carry that kind of is popular not just even in one region, but in several regions. Which then what we could do, research-wise, then, is think of, okay, what AD carries have gotten skins recently that might eliminate them from contention, so you can maybe narrow down this list. If we go with that first part in the popular female AD carry, well, let's look at some of the AD carries in that regard who just recently got skins and haven't gotten skins in a long time. Ashe, at the point of recording this video, they just announced that they're coming out with like a Fae Dragon skin for her in patch 10.20. I don't know, since this ultimate skin is supposed to be out before the end of 2020, if she would be getting two skins back to back like that. Caitlyn, meanwhile, her last skin was actually the Arcade Caitlyn skin, if I remember correctly, which was back last year and not this year, so she is in contention for getting at least another skin before the end of the year, possibly anyways. I don't know if they go to her directly. She has popped up in the meta rather recently, but if there's really an ultimate skin that's been in the works for a while, the recent meta probably wouldn't affect Riot's decision making on that point. The next one would be Jinx. Obviously, we're a Jinx channel. It'd be kind of funny to see like a Jinx ultimate skin after we just talked about ultimate skins and we kind of joked around about Jinx getting one. Obviously, we're biased here. At the same time, her last skin was this year. It was earlier in February, so it has been at least half a year and so, and I don't think she's getting two skins in 1 year either. This mainly just to kind of eliminate who hasn't gotten a skin in a minute that might be getting the skin, by the way. Obviously, they could pull a fast one and give it to any of these champions that we're talking about, Jinx included, but I just don't think they're going to possibly do that. Kai'Sa, meanwhile, is another one who is apparently getting a prestige skin. It might be later this year, if I recall correctly. I'd have to look up the post by the time I'm in editing, but it might not be Kai'Sa for that matter either, because she's apparently already getting a prestige skin. Kalista, meanwhile, hasn't gotten a skin since like 2016, I want to say, but she's also not necessarily a popular AD carry either. I mean, she can be in pro play, but just as a like region, like thematically and stuff wise, is why some people are actually pointing to Jinx right now, and maybe some other AD carries that we'll get into, is because thematically some of those resonate a lot more than Kalista has. Not that Kalista's unpopular and completely garbage or anything like that, but just saying, in terms of when they say like popular, they don't necessarily mean the meta. They don't necessarily mean pro play. They mean a couple of things. And so Kalista, she could be in there for the fact that she hasn't gotten a skin in a while, but not necessarily for anything else. Kindred, if you remember, is Lamb and Wolf, as a matter of fact. That's both of them. They're kindred spirits kind of a thing. And Lamb and Wolf just got a skin in the Spirit Blossom event, so I really don't think it's going to be them either. I think their popularity shot up with the skin, though. That skin, I've seen so much art of that skin versus just regular Kindred or any of their other skins that I mean, heck, I don't know, maybe. Misfortune is the one that got like the last ultimate skin before they kind of took a step back to really evaluate ultimate skins. Some people have joked and said this will be like Misfortune ultimate skin number two to kind of make up for the first one. So she could, I guess, be on there for that specific reason. Like what we could find out is it's actually just a retooling of the Gun Goddess Misfortune skin, and they've made it more of an ultimate skin. That could be a possibility on the table. I don't know if they're really gonna go with giving not only an ultimate skin to the same class, like twice in a row, but to the same champion in the class. Probably not. Senna, meanwhile, just got the High Noon skin. She's been kind of popular for a bit now since her release. The whole idea of like bringing a champion from the lore into the game and back and progressing the stuff is something that kind of has resonated a bit, but because she just got that High Noon skin like 2-3 months ago, I don't know if she's on the list potentially for that. Quinn, meanwhile, probably can be, because Quinn resonates with at least some people sometimes somewhere, and she also hasn't gotten a skin in quite a many moons at this point. Sivir, meanwhile, also, her last skin was like the Blood Moon skin, I believe, and then before that was the pizza skin, which was really the pizza. They make pizza look really good in that skin, by the way. But those are two champions that haven't gotten skins in a while back-to-back right there. Tristana, meanwhile, I want to say recently got a skin. It was the cosplay skin. I forget the exact name, but it was like the April Fools. It was around April this year that they got that skin. I forget the exact name of it, but because they got a skin this year, maybe they're off the table for that. Vayne just got the Spirit Blossom skin, or I guess it's like the Night Blossom skin. There's like a difference between the two of them. And then Xayah, last but not least, her last skin, I believe, was actually last year. So she's kind of popular. She's in pro play now and then. That ultimate nerf kind of hurt her, it looks like, a little bit, at least in pro play, for safety and stuff, but she could be overdue for one. Now, yes, Some people have noted that in the translation, the one person that translated Unsurrender at 20 says that their translation skills, English is not their first language, so the grammar might be off and stuff like that too. Some people have seen the word excited in there, so they're actually, like, a lot of people are actually legitimately pointing towards Jinx, which would be actually surprising. I'm not going to act like I'm going to be would be completely upset by that, because, we, like I said, we are a Jinx channel, but I would be a little bit surprising to see Jinx. I mean, when Get Jinx came out, that was popular for a while, and it's still probably kind of she is like a popular champion, even if she's not a meta champion, but a lot of these champions are. And so now we progress into the second part of this, which said, okay, it might not be just the female AD carries, it might be an AD carry period. And they specifically mentioned in the translation, at least, things like Jhin or Ashe or Teemo. And if you look at a champion like Jhin, for example, well, he would actually hit all of the notes, wouldn't he? In terms of, like, he resonated pretty well when it came out. His last skin, though, was the Dark Cosmic Jhin skin that was in 2019. So it has been a year since that skin has come out. His whole kind of thing, how he plays and stuff like that, the his character, what I'm trying to say, is something that some people think is actually pretty neat, pretty cool. He was in the thematic for Awaken and stuff like that. It could be Jhin, for that matter, the artistically inclined champion, AD carry, with all of his movements and his kit and stuff like that. It could make for a pretty sick ultimate skin, for that matter, if we're going to expand it beyond those into other AD carries, right? Like, Aphelios, I'd say, I don't know if he's, like, resonated and popular, or is he just really strong still, and that's why he's still around? Which is funny, because they're also buffing him in 10.20, so that'll be interesting to see. But obviously at that point then, it expands to some other AD carries that you might want to mention, if they've gotten a skin in a while or not. Like, Graves technically counts as an AD carry slash marksman, but would you consider him like a popular champion? If you're a Graves main, by the way, watching this, you can. The answer can be yes. You can say yes, by the way. Draven, for example, is another champion who, even if he's not super meta, is kind of popular for different reasons, right? So who do you think would be getting the ultimate skin if that's really the case? I have to make a statement, like a bet, so that way if I'm wrong, you know, I'm wrong, but if I'm right, I don't look like a hindsight hero and say later on, oh, I knew it was going to be that champion. And again, because it's a leak, I want to caution you that it is a leak. Things could change. The translation could be off here, by the way, as well. Things could not line up later, or it could be completely right, but because it was leaked, Riot decides to change some things, like the champion that decided to pick for it, or things like that. So please keep that in mind. There's nothing really out much more than this Reddit post, and then some people trying to translate what they're getting from the post itself. I'm obviously, as a Jinx channel, we gotta vote for Jinx as being the one getting it. I don't know if that's gonna be the case, because the Heartseeker, that's what it was, the Sweetheart skin came out earlier this year, and I like I said, I don't think they're gonna do it back to back. The last time Jinx got two skins in 1 year was because she hadn't gotten a skin in a year and a half since her release. So when she got Firecracker, they left that skin available. It was supposed to be like most Lunar Revel skins, actually a legacy skin, or not a legacy skin, but it got locked away after a time. But because that was her first skin since release, they let it be, which is why then when Slayer came out for the Harrowing later, that one is one that you only get for like a limited time, as it is. I don't think they want to repeat that really with this champion, or any champion if they can really help it, but I'll still say it for the sake of this channel and what it's mainly about. But again, just remember, it's a leak, it could be wrong, it could be foul, it could not be true, and there we go. That's gonna be it for this video, though. There we go. An ultimate skin leak on the back of the ultimate skin video we made recently, and that it could be for Jinx. Obviously, it always could be for any champion, to be honest. But that's all for this video for us. So thank you so much for watching this video. Make sure to like, comment, subscribe, hit the bell notification, the actual subscribe button. But I don't know which video will be next, because life can have a lot of kinks. So until next time, take care. GG, get jinxed. Thank you for watching, and enjoy pizza responsibly.